Hello children, now in this video I'm going to just explain you how to add the measures of time. So you don't have to do the normal addition here. It is something entirely different from the normal addition. So any measures of time, whether it's hours, minutes, seconds, month, days, week, year, the same concept is to be applied, which I am going to tell you. So, for addition of measures of time, let me take one example. Let us take 40 hours and 55 minutes is to be added to 37 hours and 32 minutes. Okay. So 40 hours 55 minutes and 37 hours 32 minutes. These two you have to add. The first thing is you have to arrange in a column. So two measures of times are given. One is hours, another is minutes. Just write it, write the units on the top, and then write the time below that. 40 hours, 40 hours, 55 minutes, just place it here, 55 minutes, 37 hours, you have to add 37 hours, and 32 minutes, 32 minutes. Now, okay, this is normal. As you do the addition, do it. No carry, nothing. Full minutes will be added under minutes, and hours just add and place it under the hours. So 87, and just write it here, 77. But this is not the answer. What you have to do? You have to just decompose these minutes. You know, 60 minutes equals to 1 hour. 60 minutes equals to 1 hour. I'm writing here. So what you have to do here? You have to subtract 60 from 87, and this 60 minutes will give 1 hour here. This will be subtracted and it will come to hours. When it will come, 60 minutes will go to hours, it becomes 1 hour. See? So when 60 minutes you are subtracting, आप इसको निकाल रहे हैं, तो ये कहां जाएगा? It will go to hours. तो hours की पास आके क्या बनेगा? 60 नहीं बनेगा. It will become 1 hour. So, here you have to add 1 hour and subtract 60 from this. When you subtract 60, how much you get? 27. And when you add 1 here in 77, how much you will get? 78. So now what answer you get? 78 hours and 27 minutes. This is the answer. Okay. One more example I'll give you. Let us take one more example. So, second example, twelve days 15 hours. And 26 days, 13 hours. You have to add. So first what I told you, just write the units on the top. The two measures of time are given, days and hours. And now place the time below this, 12 days. Just 12, write it here. 15 hours. 15 hours. 26 days, you have to add 13 hours. Okay. Now, add it. Full hours will be added together and write it here. And days will be added here and place it below that. 38. Now, in one day, how many hours are there? In one day, how many hours? 24 hours, isn't it? 24 hours. So what you have to do? Remove 24 hours from here. 24 hours. Just remove it. Subtract it. And this 24 hours, it will go to days and it becomes one day. Here you have to add 1. So add 1 to 38, you get 39. And subtract this, you get 4. So what is the answer? 39 days and 4 hours. Relation. Here also you have to remember the relation. One day, 24 hours. So here 28 hours they have given. Remove 24 and give one day to in the column of days. Minus 24 plus one day. This 24 has moved to days. And when it moves to days, it becomes one day. One more example let me take. Okay. So, let us take one more example. Three columns I'll take 25 hours, 39 minutes and 38 seconds. Added to, it is to be added 14 hours, 46 minutes. Okay. Write all the three measures of time on the top. Hours, minutes and seconds. So hours, minutes and seconds. And now write the time below these measures of time. So you have to add it, 25 hours, 39 minutes, 38 seconds, added to 14 hours, 46 minutes and 40 seconds. Now first add it and keep it. Now, you know 1 minute equals 60 seconds. Relation you remember? So you have to just remove 60 from this and give 1 minute to this minute column. Plus 1. So how many seconds are remaining now? It is 18 seconds. Clear this one? Now you have got 86 minutes. 1 hour equals 60 minutes. So remove 60 from minutes and give 1 hour to 39 hours. How much is now minutes? 26 minutes. And this becomes 40 hours. So what is the answer? 40 hours, 26 minutes, 18 seconds. When you add 25 hours, 39 minutes, 38 seconds to 14 hours, 46 minutes, 40 seconds, you get 40 hours, 26 minutes, 18 seconds. I hope now, children, addition is clear to you. Remember the relationship of measures of time and apply it here. As you subtract the first relation, remember the second, that how much it has to give it. Again, you have to subtract and give the relationship of measures of time to the next measure of time. And this way it will proceed. Thank you, children. Keep smiling. Be safe.